Now, in today's class, we'll see how are we going to transform this artwork, this is called PCB artwork, into a real PCB. So how do we manufacture PCBs? How do we actually, you know, fabricate PCBs from the artwork is the discussion of today's class. The first step starts with the schematic design. You can use any software, but then for our case, we are using Proteus. So that first, we need to design the schematic. One of the important concepts that you will always remember in your life is never design PCB without validating and verifying the circuit in breadboard. Very important thumb rule that you will always remember in your life. Never design PCBs without validating and verifying the circuit in a breadboard model. If you are not sure whether the circuit will work or not, there is no point in designing a PCB. And later on rework the PCB. That's a very bad way of doing it. First, verify and validate the circuit in a breadboard model and be 100% sure that this circuit will work. Only then we can proceed for PCB. PCB is after all the final stage of the product. Before that, you should make sure that the product works. And using breadboard, you first validate that. So that is the first thing. And then the process of PCB designing starts with the designing schematic that we did in the previous class. And then the next stage of PCB designing is component placement and routing. So we did the placement and routing part in the previous class. So we positioned the components and then we started routing them. So that part we completed in the previous class. And then next stage is how are we going? This is called PCB artwork. This PCB artwork we have to transform into a real-time PCB. So before we do that, we do some 3D visualization on the optimization. What do you mean by optimization? Sometimes the components may be too close. Sometimes you may have empty spaces, too much of empty spaces. For example, you can see there is too much empty space here. And you can also see that these two components are very close. So likewise, you can observe the PCB and do some kind of optimization. So the objective is to reduce the overall size. Overall size means this length versus width I am talking about. So you have to keep these two figures as small as possible. Let us say, for example, this length is equal to 10 centimeters and this width is equal to 8 centimeters. Let us say, for example, the size of the PCB in this case, normally we refer them in square centimeters. So it is 10 is length, 8 is width. So we have 80 centimeters square or 80 square centimeter. So when you fabricate a PCB, normally we outsource this work because designing a PCB is not our cup of tea. As a designer, you can design the PCB, but then fabrication we normally outsource, though it is possible to do that at home. When you outsource this, vendors normally charge you for what is the cost of this PCB per square centimeter. In the fourth step, we need to generate the manufacturing. Manufacturing files means the files that will help us to manufacture the PCB. There are four important files that we need. I am just showing all the four. The first file is the bottom copper layer. So the bottom copper layer is the one which is going to have all the tracks. So that is the heart of your PCB. So that is one file that we need. The second file that we need is the top sill screen layer. Top sill screen is needed for printing these legends and then giving your brand name, your website, the components, outer boundary that is used for component identification. So this is necessary for, why should we do this process actually? We need this for component identification. So after designing the PCB, we need to assemble the PCB, right? So where to put what? So that is what it is. So I know what is D1, D2. So D1 is a diode, C2 is a capacitor, D1 is voltage regulator. So that gives me identification where exactly I should put the component and solder. Otherwise you will be in you may not be able to identify where to put which component. So that will be a big problem later on. So this top sill screen layer is normally printed in white ink. It will give you a finishing look for your PCB. So this is on the top side. So these two sides are very important for the PCB. Two additional files that we need are, one is the solder mask, bottom solder mask. What is solder mask? Solder mask is a green colored ink that we normally use for coating our PCB in the track side, so that the PCB tracks are not corroded. But when you apply the solder mask, we have to make sure that these pads are not applied with the solder mask. Otherwise, we cannot solder them. So we have to cover these pads and the rest of the area, we need to apply the solder mask. So this solder mask file will give you a black shade in the places of all the pads. The other areas will be open, which means all these empty spaces we would apply solder mask, and solder mask will not go in the padded areas. Here there is no mask. So this is yet another file that we need for applying solder mask in the bottom layer. So wherever you have tracks, we need. So in case if you are designing a two-layer PCB, we need two such files, one for top layer and the other one for the bottom layer. Since we are having only one layer here, bottom layer, we need only one solder mask file. And the last file that we need is a drill file. Okay, drill file is necessary for putting holes in the pads. So each pad has a hole. So normally, if you do manual drilling, this is not necessary. But in large-scale manufacturing, they go for automated drilling. Automated drilling means there will be a CNC machine which would automatically, if you feed the X and Y coordinates, the drill bit, we call that as drill bit, the drill bit automatically position itself in the exact point and then it will drill a hole in the PCB. So for this, we needed to have this file. This is necessary only when you go for automated CNC drilling. If you are manual drilling, then we can do some visual inspection and start drilling it. So normally we do manual drilling only for one or two bolts. For high volume productions, they go for automated drilling. So it is necessary that we should also give drill file. So there are four different files that we needed to generate. First one is the copper layer file, which has all the tracks. This will give all the electrical connection for the component. The second file is the top silkscreen layer file. This is used for identifying the legends and different components in the top layer. The third file is the bottom solder mask, which is used for applying the green mask in the bottom layer. So in the shaded zones, there will not be any mask. In the empty zones, we would have the solder mask, green solder mask applied. And the last one is the drill file. The drill file is used for drilling holes in the appropriate places in the pads. So these are the four different files that we need. Now let us go to the PCB that we designed in the previous class. So this is my PCB. All of you are able to see the PCB board here?
Yes, sir.
So this is the board that we designed in the previous class. We also saw the 3D visualization, and we also optimized the component positioning, and we are happy with the PCB now. Now it's time for us to actually go for the fabrication process. So fabrication process starts with generating the manufacturing files. So how to generate the manufacturing file? Go to output, go to print layout. In the print layout, you print all the necessary files. I need top layer, I need bottom copper layer, top silk screen. If you need bottom silk screen, that also you can give. But in this case, we don't have anything to print in the bottom side, so I'm not putting all the board edges I want, top resistant, bottom resist, and the mechanical layer. So all these layers, whichever layer that you are interested in, you just click. And then we need 100% scale. 100% scale means the exact size of the PCB I'm interested in. And choose the printer here. If you have a printer, you print it. In this case, I just convert this into a PDF file. And then I choose a file name. I save it in the desktop. Let me say BTech second year dot PDF. And then you OK. So this would generate the PCB files. I'll go to desktop, I'll go to PCB, I'll open the BTech second year file. It has given all the layers in a single file. I don't want that way. So let me do the generation part again. Output, print layout. There is an option for separate pages. Okay, so if you click that, it would give you separate page for each layer. So that way I want, I design this as BTech. Final. Click save, click OK. BTech.pdf and click OK. Now, if you open that BTech file, you have separate sheets for each file. So that's what we want. Let us see what each file is about. If you see this, let me position this. Yeah. This is the first file. Can you tell me what file is this? This is the drill file. This file is used for drilling holes in various pads. So whatever you are seeing now, the first file is the drill file. So you can see that these are the diodes and I need holes to be drilled in 2 points. The diode has two drills, through hole pads, so both the pads require drills. So all these points refer the drill wherever you want, you need to drill the holes. So this is a drill file, first one. The second file is the most important file, which is the bottom solder layer, which is where we designed all the track. So we drew one track on the top side. This has to be a 45 degree bend. So we unknowingly designed this as a 90 degree. So this you correct it later on. So this is the bottom track layer. So the exact PCB where we give electrical connections to each and every component. So this is the second layer, bottom copper layer. The third important layer is the top silk screen layer, where we give all the legend names, your brand name, your website, and the component name, identification names, all those stuff come in the top layer. And finally, the green solder mask layer, where we hide the pads. This dark black colored areas are the areas where the green mask will not be applied, except those for the entire board in the bottom side, we apply the green mask, which means the green paint will go for this entire rectangle, except the black colored zones. The black colored zones are the pads where we do the actual soldering. If you apply green mask paint in the pads also, we will not be able to solder them. That is why we mask them. So we mask our masking mirror. We cover them, we hide them, and the rest of the zones, we apply the green paint. So these are the four important files that we need, so that we generate from the PCB. That is my fourth step. Fifth step starts with the PCB fabrication process. So I take an empty PCB. So this is how your raw PCB would look like. The very first thing that I do is transfer this artwork to this PCB. So if I, this is my PCB artwork. PCB artwork means what? The bottom layer. So I transfer this, the PCB artwork to a empty PCB, and the empty PCB would look like this. This black colored tracks will be printed in the empty PCB. So transferring the artwork means what? You transfer this black colored tracks and print them. You just assume this as a plain white sheet and this is a printed sheet, so that this empty sheet becomes a printed sheet. So this, you transfer this artwork into an empty PCB. So there are a variety of methods people follow for this. I'll give you three standard ways. The most widely used technique is screen printing technique. You know what is screen printing, right? You have a screen. So you would have seen the screen printing process in the printing press, where they print visiting cards, invitations, marriage invitations, all those stuff. So they'll be having a screen, and they'll be having the screen will be having all the necessary films embossed, and then they'll put some paint on the top of the screen, and then they will wipe. So once they wipe it, the actual imprint will be transferred to the substrate. So that's called a screen printing process. That is the first method. This is the screen printing method. So this is called the screen. So in the screen, they would emboss that, develop that particular circuit. And then in the transparent areas, ink will pass through. In the other zones, ink will not get through. That means if you put some ink and then wipe that, all these transparent areas will allow the ink to get through. So let me take this. So this is the empty PCB. You just wipe the empty PCB clean and then put the PCB below the screen, paste it, and then put the screen below the screen, and then you apply some black ink. Position the screen on top of the PCB. You apply some black ink, and then you use a wiper and then wipe that. If you wipe it, the entire circuit will allow the black ink to go through, and the entire circuit is transferred to the board. So that's what it is. So you simply wipe it. In a single wipe, the entire circuit will be transferred to the copper layer. So that's how it is. So for designing one PCB and two PCB, we don't do this method. Suppose if you are doing for 100 PCBs or 200 PCBs, it is economical to take that screen. The challenge here is to prepare the screen. All the screen printing and printing press people will help you to do that. This is how you can make the same screen to prepare hundreds of PCBs. It is a matter of single wipe. This is the most widely used technique that PCB fabricators follow. The second method is photo transfer method. Before this digital photography came, we used to take photographs in a old digital camera by using camera films. So we take that camera film and give it to a Photoshop owner, and that Photoshop owner will transfer that camera films into a real life photographs using photo developing. So they develop that film, and then using the developed film, they print it. So this is similar to that. So they take this file and then apply some photosensitive material on top of this material, and they will expose this by using ultraviolet rays. And then later on, they convert that into a PCB of this sort. So you take a photosensitive material on top of the PCB board, and you expose that in a UV ultraviolet lamp in a box, so that all the light sensitive part will go off and the remaining circuit will be there in the board. It is called developing the board. So once it develops, the circuit will get transferred to the board. This is called the developing solution, photo developing solution. Okay, so after development, this will look like this. So this is also another technique. The third crude way of doing that is toner transfer. This toner transfer is not used for professional, this is used for hobby purpose. So in toner transfer, what you do, you just print this this track in a glossy paper. So you just take a print of this bottom layer in that glossy sheet, you cut that in the exact rectangle, and then put on top of this PCB, and then you use an iron box, and then you iron that. So if you put an iron box and rub on top of that, this black colored ink will be transferred to this. So that is one crude way of doing that. So this is the empty PCB. You take a normal iron box at home, and then you do some preheating. So this is the artwork. You just print this artwork in your laser printer. Make sure that you have a dark ink, and then you print this circuit artwork, PCB artwork, in the in the laser printer. And then make sure that the ink part is facing the copper side, and then you iron that. So if you put your iron for some time, what will happen? No, that ink that was there in the glossy paper will get transferred to the PCB board. We have to remove that white paper by putting that in the soap solution. You put that board in the soap solution for some time and peel off the white sheet. Later on, your copper layer will have only the copper tracks. So that is one quick and dirty way of doing it. This is not done for professional PCB manufacturing. This is done for hobbyists and students like you. Okay, this will go right. So after ironing this for 4 or 5 minutes, what is he doing? He's just transferring that to a soap solution or plain water, wherever it is. So just put that in a water tub and then wait for some time. And typically after 15-20 minutes, you just take off and then peel off that. See? Slowly you will peel off that. So you remove all the unwanted things, and then he's using brush. I don't recommend that, because if you put too much of a brush, and then the tracks will peel off. So just use your hand and then rub. Don't use brushes and all. If you use brush, what will happen? These tracks will come off. So don't use that board in a harsh manner. So this is the toner transfer method. In the toner transfer method, we use the heat coming from the iron box to transfer the circuit to the copper board. So you can use either one of the three techniques. Okay, so either one of the three techniques you follow, and then transfer the artwork to the board. That is the idea. So once you transfer the board would look like this. So this is the PCB or the copper layer with the artwork. The next step is etching. What do you mean by etching? We have to remove this copper. So you have to remove all the copper area except the tracks. So where are these tracks? These black areas. So you have to remove all the unwanted copper areas, leaving only the tracks, which is the copper layer, which is the track, black colored track. So how do we remove this copper? We put a etching solution here. The most widely used etching solution is ferric chloride. So if you prepare a ferric chloride solution and put the PCB inside, and if you shake for 15-20 minutes, the ferric chloride will eat away all the empty copper, leaving only the empty PCB. And finally, if you wash this, your final PCB would look like this. If you see, these coppers are taken away. No copper here. This is etched ferric chloride. Ferric chloride or cupric chloride. You can also use cupric chloride. So ferric chloride is the most widely used solution which we use for etching the PCB. So dissolve ferric chloride chemical in water and dilute it. If you put too much of ferric chloride, it will eat away your useful tracks also. Make sure that the concentration is not too high. Too low concentration will take more time to etch. So you will have a judicious amount of that. This is the PCB file which you are going to etch. Just put that and then shake it for a few minutes. typically after 10-15 minutes, if you take the board would normally, you know, all the copper parts, visible copper parts will be, see, all the visible copper parts will be eaten by the ferric chloride solution, leaving only the black colored tracks. Later on, we can wash that track in water. Only the these are the visible tracks. So this is the remaining portion, remaining unetched. Rest of the copper is eaten away by the ferric chloride solution. So later on, we need to put drills here and then apply the green mask and then complete the board. So this is how we etch the board. So you take a ferric chloride solution. Once you transfer the artwork to the PCB board and put it in the ferric chloride solution, and then you shake that particular solution for 5-10 minutes, the ferric chloride solution will eat away all the copper part, leaving only the empty, leaving only the tracks. Later on, we drill holes and then make. Okay, we need to apply the green mask. That is where you get the green color for your PCB. So application of green mask will cover with green paint only the rest of the areas, whereas the pads will remain empty. No green mask in pads. Green mask is applied here, the green mask ink. So I put the PCB. This green mask application is similar to a screen printing process. In the screen printing process, we have the green mask layer developed here. The green mask layer will hide all the pads. Only the tracks and the other areas will be visible. So if you apply the green mask, all the other areas will be covered with green paint except the pads. See, all the pads will be left out. Only the other green layers, rest of the layers will be covered by your green paint. Next one is silkscreen layer. Silkscreen layer is again a screen printing process. This is also a screen process. This is again a screen printing process. So instead of green ink, they use white ink and then print this in the tops. In this case, they use a white ink. See, it will have all the component names, legends, all those. Pretty simple and straightforward. The next step is how to drill holes to the PCB. We need to use a drilling machine, or we can use an automated CNC drilling machine to drill the holes in the PCB. See how it is drilling. How the machine is automatically going to the exact X and Y coordinates and putting a hole. That is why we need the drill file. So once you feed the drill file, see, with the automatic X and Y coordinates, the drill machine will automatically go to that point and then it will put a drill. Okay. So once that drilling process is over, that concludes your PCB process. The final PCB would look like this. So this is my bottom layer. This is my top layer. Okay. So in the bottom layer, you have your green mask. This is the pad. This is the silkscreen layer on the top side. So let me review what we discussed today. The first step starts with the designing of schematic. The second step is the component placement and routing the PCB. The third step is optimizing the PCB by visualizing that in 3D. Fourth step is generating the manufacturing files. There are 4 important files that we need. First one is the bottom copper layer track file. The second file is the top silkscreen layer. The third file is green mask file for application of green mask. And the fourth file is the drill bit. Except the drill, all the three are used for screen printing. This is also screen printing. This is also screen printing. And this is also screen printing. This is screen printed with black ink. This is screen printed with green ink. This is screen printed with white ink. And the drill is used for automatic CNC drilling. So next step is transferring the artwork to the empty PCB, and then that black colored tracks are transferred to your empty PCB. So we saw 3 different techniques. One is screen printing, the other one is photo transfer, the other one is toner transfer. The most widely used technique is your screen printing technique. So this is simple and straightforward, and it is very effective also. So this black ink, if you simply wipe, the entire circuit is transferred to your copper board. And then we used etching method. So we put that copper with artwork into a etching solution. Ferric chloride is the most widely used solution, and if you put the PCB in that ferric chloride solution, and then if you wait for some time, the ferric chloride solution will eat away the copper part, leaving only the circuit. And then you apply the green mask. Application of green mask is done by screen printing, and we finally apply the silkscreen layer. Later we drill holes, and finally the PCB would look like this. This is the chemical process. There is also another way of designing the PCB directly from this stage. Which stage I am talking about? you can directly transfer this instead of putting this in a PCB and chemically etching it. It is also mechanically, it is also possible for you to use a CNC milling machine and then design this piece. So this will not involve any chemical process. Rather, the bit will directly draw the PCB on top of a copper. So it will just cut away the copper part and draw the tracks. This is called milling. Wherever that bit is going, that copper is eliminated out. So it is drawing a track by drawing two lines, which means a track is formed by whenever this bit is drawing two lines, that small portion of copper between, see, the copper in between these two lines is the track. This is the pad, and there is no electrical connection between this layer and this layer with the copper layer. This copper layer now becomes an island. Now this becomes a track for me. Do you understand? This is called CNC milling machine. So this does not involve any chemical etching, so on and so forth. This will directly transfer the PCB circuit in a copper board. But this is a time consuming process, typically helpful for designing one or two boards. But large volume production, this method cannot be used. This may be used only for prototyping and checking your PCB, whether the PCB is working all right or not. CNC milling machine. This fellow will take the artwork. If you feed the artwork to a milling machine, you will get the PCB output. Okay, so that is another way of doing it. This is only for prototyping purpose. Only prototyping means what? Only validating your PCB. For large volumes, this will not be useful because it will take large time.